Hello and welcome to this discussion about climate justice here from the European Parliament. For someone who has never heard of the concept, what is climate justice and why is it important?
Climate justice begins with the injustice of climate change and links climate change, development and human rights, recognizing that those who are most vulnerable in the places that they live in to climate change very often are the least responsible for what's causing it, but are the most affected and need to be able to benefit from the clean energy, for example, that we're providing. So it's partly recognizing the injustice of how climate change affects these people, but also saying we must help them to benefit quickly. It's really saying, climate change is an issue that is a human issue, a development issue, an economic issue, an environmental issue, an ecosystem issue, but it's mainly an issue about gender and human rights and people.
What does gender equality and climate justice have in common? Climate change and gender equality. How is that connected?
It's very linked to each other, and I'm so happy to sit here next to Mary Robinson, who is a great role model in this struggle, really, towards climate justice. Sometimes people get surprised, but it's really connected in so many ways. I just visited India, and the water, just the question about clean water. And of course, it's always the poorest people, the poorest community, who are most badly hit of the bad water, the total destroyal of water resources. And it's always the women and the children who are, well, usually they are the sole responsible for collecting water, for doing the dishes, for cleaning, all of these things, but also they sell the fish. So we think that empowering women is a very efficient tool to achieve climate justice on a global scale.
Janne Staffansson, when we hear mostly reports from countries in Africa, Asia and low-lying island nations far away, we don't often get to hear about how the Sami people already now are being seriously impacted by climate changes. How does climate change affect your livelihood and culture, would you say?
It's a big question you ask of me. I was born with climate change and raised with climate change consequences. So it's not a threat, as many people think. And it's affecting my everything that I am and everything that I do and my entire identity and culture, my everyday life. And some people might think that we belong to the vulnerable groups, of course. But we are not vulnerable, we are fighting. We're fighting hard. Every day. And some people might also call us poor, but we are so rich in knowledge and resilience and adaptation skills. And these things are not often taken up to the surface. And when you talk about climate change, it's often not talked about the Arctic issues. Our lands that are disappearing, the ices that are melting and laying on top of the Pacific Islands.
So what can we do? Mrs. Robinson.
I think there's a lot that we are doing now since the Paris Climate Agreement. It was an extraordinarily fair agreement, not strong enough in enforcement provisions, but very fair because the smallest islands, the least developed countries, the poorest communities were listened to. And then we got the goal of staying well below 2 degrees and working for 1.5 degrees. But what we can do is we can move rapidly to a clean energy world. And get renewable energy to the 1.3 billion who don't have any access. Move more rapidly in Europe and the United States and the developed parts of the world to have a 2050 mentality. We're going to be carbon neutral at or well before 2050. And how do we work backwards and make that happen? That's the key.
Linnea Engström, what can you do as a part of this House, the European Parliament? How will you continue the work?
Well, I'm working on legislative files, which is, for example, enhancing the responsibility and the transparency of the EU fleet, for example. With this initiative report on climate justice, we will try to raise also the institutional perspective, really, to say that also the finance has to go. I mean, we're talking about active citizenship, basically, because what we've seen in the north is people, you know, claiming their rights and having a kind of a knowledge about their own history. I think we have to see that more. But also, like, the finance has to go to the right people. This is really about democratization of the whole system, and also about justice, of course.
This is the first climate justice report of the European Parliament, and I'm really pleased that this is happening, because it is so important.
It's very strange that it hasn't happened before.
Exactly.
But that just shows us, like, the really crucial issues are usually not raised to this level. So I'm very, very glad that we're doing this right now.